Hi, welcome, and thank you for watching. This is my first attempt at painting since November. I normally try to avoid working from photographs, but not much about it you can do these days. So I thought I'd just start trying to get back into it, back into practice. What I did was set up an old monitor vertically in portrait mode and put up a photo and just start working from it. My goal with all this is to try and eyeball it all the way through the whole, and finish up something that looks like a painting all the way through. It's mainly a practice thing, practicing my accuracy in drawing, in color, and as well, most importantly, just speed. Of course, I encountered quite a few hiccups on this first one. There's technical problems, the lighting's really bad at the end, and I apologize for that, but hopefully these will get better as I progress and keep doing these. The first 10 minutes is drawing, and I'm going to leave that in real time. And then after that, I'm going to just go ahead and speed it up a little bit, just so moves a little quicker. The whole painting took an hour and about 17 minutes. 1 hour, 17 minutes. I did take breaks because I had to readjust some things with the camera, with the image. That's good practice. I'm going to put up more of these, and I hope you enjoy it, get something out of it. Thanks. And by the way, I'm using a gessoed panel. It's just a Luan, quarter inch Luan that's been gessoed and then tinted with a raw umber as a tone. And I start the initial drawing with burnt sienna wash with just turpentine as a medium. That's it. All right, and the image I'm using, the portrait, is actually a copyrighted photo, so I'm legally not allowed to show it when I'm working here. So even though it's from a popular free model DVD, I still can't show it while I'm doing this, so sorry about that.
Thank you. encouraging to you? So they say. I say to Sandy, some of my tears came in the porch and their relationships with women. Anyway, love it. The beat, the flute. Oh, man. Before that, another groove. Then it's Newborn Junior playing one of Sonny Rollins' most famous compositions called Odeo. It's from 1961. It was Newborn Junior on piano, Sam Jones on bass, and Bruce Hayes on drums. That was Cam Barley's rhythm section. He started off that one set with the great Stanley Turrentine with a soulful saxophone. He had every note just dripping with feeling. I loved it. And it's an album called Hustlin', and the song was called Something Happens to Me, 1964, with Kenny Burrell on guitar, Shirley Scott on Hammond B. Arden, Bob Pancho on bass, and Bruce Finch on drums. And so, a lot of up-tempo stuff. I'm gonna get back into a different kind of a mood, and one of my favorite, I mean, all stuff's my favorite, right? But I just love the way the jazz musicians play balance. And one of the great trumpet players, Clifford Brown, was a master of that too. Just his beautiful tone and his expressiveness. Everything about his style just blew everybody away. Died when he was 26, but left a great legacy. And this is from when he was recorded live with the Art Blakey Messengers, and the song's called Once in a While. It's a feature of Clifford Brown. So I just dig his, again, beautiful subtone, expressiveness, the emotion, everything. And right after that, you'll hear someone playing with Clifford Brown with Art Blakey as Lou Johnson. Also, beautiful tone on alto sax. And then right after that, we're going to end up with some alla Jamal. First of all, let's hear Clifford Brown holding forth on Once in a While, right here on Portland Jazz Radio, Kingdom State. Jazz from one of the premier jazz groups of the time. That was Miles Davis Quintet, 1961, from an album called Saturday at the Blackhawk in San Francisco, filmed in San Francisco. There's also a Friday night at the Blackhawk, as a double album. That was one of the first albums I ever had in my life. Someone gave that to me. Just blew my mind. I said, got to hear some live jazz. And that was, you know, in Miles' group, you didn't half step. There was no half step, and everybody was full into the groove. And that was a good example of that. So Miles Davis on trumpet, Hank Mobley on tenor sax, Quentin Kelly, great accompaniment on piano. Paul Chambers on bass, and Jimmy Cobb on drums. Hope you enjoy that, and it tastes something different. And the next, I'm going to play another live performance. It's kind of vocal. One of my favorite jazz blues performers, and that's the Rawls. And you can just hear the audience come alive. I mean, it's the beginning of the set, and you hear the announcer, and Lou comes in and takes control. And it's from a Lou Rawls live album. It's called, they call it, Stormy Monday. The blues with some jazz and inflections. So here we go for another ride with Lou Rawls. Right here on Portland Jazz Radio, KMHB. Thanks for coming. Thank you.
Thank you.
this took about an hour and 17 minutes, approximately. Lots of problems, lots of issues, drawing, structure, it's a mess, but that's what I'm here for, to learn, to figure things out, and hopefully get better. All right. Thank you for watching. If you made it this far, appreciate it.